Who is the biggest dinosaur? Welcome to the Natural History of Dinosaurs. My name is Benjamin Berger. I'm a paleontologist at Utah State University, teaching in the heart of Utah's dinosaur country in Vernal. Now, as we've seen, dinosaurs come in a wide variety of sizes. Many were tiny, but during the late Jurassic and into the Cretaceous, a particular group of dinosaurs got really, really big. The biggest of the dinosaurs belong to the long-neck Sauropoda, a group of saurischian lizard-hip dinosaurs that first appeared in the late Triassic. These lumbering, plant-eating dinosaurs became enormous from 150 to 66 million years ago. So who was the largest of these large sauropods? Who was the biggest dinosaur? Now, before we go on, we have to figure out how we're going to rank the size of these giant dinosaurs. Dinosaurs are only known from really old, millions of years old, fossils, which are often very fragmentary, and they are often not very easy to translate into comparable numbers between specimens. So we can't really pick the biggest dinosaur out of a lineup. Now, with modern animals, we can weigh animals using scales. Now, the largest land animal that has ever been weighed is the African bush elephant. In the Guinness Book of World Records, a male individual weighed 12.3 tons. However, the average weight of all the measured adult living elephants have been weighed is 4.9 tons. So we can see that within a single species, there's considerable differences in weight. So when we look at dinosaurs, we have to realize that they don't have large numbers of individual specimens of each species. We mostly have a single specimen or two of each species or genus. So we may never have a number distribution of weights for each and every species. Now, the biggest living animal is the blue whale, which, since it lives in buoyant water, can reach weights estimated up to 180 tons. Although these are estimates, as it's challenging to weigh a blue whale. In dinosaurs, weight is nearly impossible to determine, and that's because we just have a few bones. We need to estimate the mass of the dinosaur and the volume. And these are two really difficult estimates to make from just bones, especially since there is evidence that sauropods lightened their body using a pneumatic air system. A balloon and a bowling ball might have the same size, but one is clearly heavier than the other. But what about height and length? In elephants, we can easily measure the height with an average of around 3.2 meters, around 10 feet tall. But in dinosaurs, we rarely have a complete skeleton, especially in the largest specimens. Height is also problematic with sauropod dinosaurs, as how do you measure that long neck? Do they reach up with their neck, or was their neck more horizontal? The length of the dinosaur is also problematic, as you rarely have every single caudal vertebrae in the tail and have every single cervical vertebrae in the neck and skull, all the vertebrae, the entire thing, to get at the length of the dinosaur. With most of these dinosaurs, you're dealing with only fragmentary bones. All right, to make comparisons, I'm going to compare three measurements. The first, the length of the femur. The second is the length of the humerus, and the third is the diameter and area of the dorsal vertebra centrum. Now, I've picked these three measurements because both the femur and the humerus are common elements of the skeleton that often preserve. So we can compare many specimens with each other. Now, there are still many specimens we're going to look at that lack limb bones. So then we can compare the size of the vertebrae. But this is problematic in that centrum sizes can vary in the vertebral series. So often these really large bones are fragmentary, and there's going to be a lot of error in some of these estimates. Now, I've searched around for measurements of bones in known specimens, sometimes thumbing measurements from figures and making a list of what I think are the top 18 largest dinosaurs. Now, I made it more than 10 because we really don't know which one of these dinosaurs are the biggest. And the more, I guess, I put into the list, that would give me a little extra chance at being right that one of these 18 dinosaurs was actually the biggest. Now, the top-ranked dinosaur, in my own opinion, is the largest. However, all of these dinosaurs have estimated lengths of over 100 to 150 feet, more than the length of an adult blue whale. All right, drum roll. Here are my top 18 largest dinosaurs. Number 18, Paralititan from North Africa, from the late Cretaceous of Egypt, discovered in the western desert of the Bahrain Formation. Paralititan is a titanosaur, one of the biggest dinosaurs ever from Africa. Its humerus length was 1.69 meters, so about my height. Oh my goodness, and we're only at number 18. Well, I guess it's small compared to the ones coming up. Number 17, Diplodocus, from the late Jurassic of North America, from the Morrison Formation, which has a femur length of 1.5 meters and one of the better known sauropods on this list. Some dinosaurs we'll mention later are often considered large specimens of Diplodocus, but have been given different names. Number 16, Seismosaurus, which today is recognized as an individual of the genus Diplodocus. It was discovered in 1979, and excavations began in the 1980s to dig it out by Dave Gillette from a late Jurassic Morrison Formation of New Mexico. Now, Seismosaurus was named after a seismic survey that was used to help excavate the fossils, which was actually used in the first Jurassic Park movie. Now, unfortunately, Seismosaurus is only known from the rows of vertebrae and the hip bones, including the ischium, with an estimated length of about 150 feet. Although, since the specimen lacks limbs, it's a bit difficult to compare with other specimens. Number 15, Notocolossus, which is a South American dinosaur. It's a large titanosaur which had a humerus that measured 1.76 meters in length. The dinosaur was described in 2016 from Argentina, where a number of supersized sauropod titanosaurs have been found. Number 14, the difficult to pronounce Futalognkosaurus, another large sauropod from South America belonging to the titanosaur group. It was described in 2007. The vertebral column is slightly larger than Notocolossus, although less of the specimen is known of this dinosaur. Number 13, Brachiosaurus, a large late Jurassic dinosaur from the Morrison Formation of North America. Brachiosaurus was a forward-built dinosaur, and if you use the length of the humerus, which was over 2 meters long, Brachiosaurus had one of the largest forearms of all known dinosaurs. However, Brachiosaurus likely was not as long in length, and that's because it had a shorter tail than found in Diplodocus. Now, Brachiosaurus is one of the best-known sauropod dinosaurs. Number 12, Giraffatitan from the late Jurassic of Africa, which is one of the tallest dinosaurs ever. A massively big sauropod, it has a few centimeters on the humeral length than Brachiosaurus, with a length of 2.13 meters. Number 11, Sauroposeidon, which is known from the early Cretaceous of Oklahoma. It's only known from a partial neck, including some massively huge cervical vertebrae, which are larger than Giraffatitan and Brachiosaurus. Sauroposeidon may have been the tallest dinosaur by a wide margin. Number 10, Dreadnoughtus. A very large dinosaur from the late Cretaceous of South America with a great name. Dreadnoughtus is known from most of the body, fairly complete specimen, except it sadly lacks a skull. The length of the humerus was 1.6 meters, so shorter than Giraffatitan and Brachiosaurus. But the femur is really long, at 1.91 meters, almost breaking the 2-meter mark for the thigh bone. Number 9, this is one of the more controversial dinosaurs on our list, Amphiocolis. It's based on a specimen that was collected over 100 years ago here in North America, only briefly described in a quick description in a paper by Edward Cope. The specimen was lost, perhaps being tossed out after Edward Cope died and his collection was transferred to New York. Only a part of the vertebrae was figured, but depending on the reconstruction of the vertebrae, it would have been a really, really big dinosaur. I estimate the diameter of the centrum to have been about half a meter or so. So that's about twice the size of Notocolossus. But we really don't have any more of this specimen. If these measurements are true, it blows everybody else out of the water. But with an incorrect recorded scale on the original figure, it's doubtful it was this big. Number 8, Apatosaurus. Apatosaurus is the original Brontosaurus, and it still makes this list with its large size and giant neck. It's from the late Jurassic of North America, at a femur length of 1.5 meters, well in the range of these giants. It's also one of the best known large sauropod dinosaurs. Number 7, Supersaurus, is a massive specimen discovered in the late Jurassic Morrison Formation of Colorado. It's discovered by Vivian Jones, who's a uranium prospector. Now, we don't have a femur or a humerus of this dinosaur, but the scapular coracoid was giant, huge. And a dorsal vertebrae, which originally was named Ultrasaurus, is now considered part of the same specimen. It's likely was related to Barosaurus or Diplodocus, although initially it's thought to belong more closely with Brachiosaurus. Now, a new skeleton was found in Wyoming as Supersaurus, which includes a tibia and various cervical and dorsal vertebrae. So far, no one's found a skull. Number 6, Alamosaurus, the giant late Cretaceous dinosaur from North America. This is a titanosaur which may have invaded North America at the end of the Cretaceous period from South America. One partial femur has an estimated length of around 1.6 meters, which is about my own height. So this is very massive specimens are known from New Mexico, ranging into Utah, but they're unknown north of the Utah-Wyoming border. Number 5, Ruyangosaurus, which is a large late Cretaceous dinosaur from China, which is not as well known as other dinosaurs. Ruyangosaurus is the only giant dinosaur on our list from China. Described in 2009, its femur was 2.35 meters in length, which makes it the biggest femur on our list so far. Number 4, Brachiosaurus, which is a mouthful to say. This dinosaur was discovered in India in the late Cretaceous, and when it was first discovered, it was mistaken as a giant theropod dinosaur. Based on published measurements, the length of the tibia was 2 meters, which is nearly twice the size of Dreadnoughtus. Little of this dinosaur is known beyond this specimen, and it's strange to find such a large dinosaur on the Indian continent, which at the time during the Cretaceous was isolated from the rest of Asia. Number 3, Puertasaurus, which is known from the Middle Cretaceous of South America. Now this creature was really big, with a very large centrum. Now, we don't have any limbs of this dinosaur, and not much beyond its vertebrae. Some scientists estimate a smaller size, but with a massive size of the centrum, it's up there near the top for now. Number two, the currently unnamed Titanosaur, which will soon get a new name, which was discovered in South America in the late Cretaceous. Now, this Titanosaur specimen has an estimated femur length of 2.6 meters, which is really big, the biggest femur so far. Now, this specimen has not been formally described yet as of March 2016, but scientists have been estimating the size of this creature for some time since its discovery. If these measurements prove true, then this dinosaur might exceed the next dinosaur and be crowned the largest, biggest dinosaur ever. The specimen is currently on display at the American Museum of Natural History in New York City. All right, number one, the largest dinosaur that ever existed, Argentinosaurus, which is a late Cretaceous South American titanosaur. Now, this dinosaur exceeds most dinosaurs when we look at its skeleton. We lack a humerus and a complete femur for this dinosaur, but if we estimate the femur length by looking at the known fibula and the hip bones, which are known, we put a guess about 2.95 meters for this femur. Now, a mounted skeleton based on the scale of recovered bones is on display down in Argentina. Now, no dinosaur has a femur length larger than 3 meters. So this thing was on the edge of that, so it was really big. It was so big that it could walk easily over an adult elephant. Now, it may be that the unnamed titanosaur is a large individual of Argentinosaurus, but nevertheless, Argentinosaurus is a massively huge titanosaur from South America, and it's one of the biggest for sure. The vertebrae were 1.56 meters tall. That's taller than me. And reconstructions of this dinosaur place it at 130 feet long, with quite a bit of debate in the scientific community, and the estimated weight is about 80 tons, or about 8 large elephants. Now, don't be surprised if more giant dinosaurs are announced that vie for that largest dinosaur ever spot. And in reality, all of these dinosaurs were equally large and massive, and debating which one was the biggest, well, we may never ever be able to answer that. The more we look for giant dinosaurs, the more likely we are to find even bigger ones. All right, so you should now be able to debate which dinosaur was the biggest and be able to evaluate the challenges facing paleontologists in determining the size and approximate weight in dinosaurs.